Hi, I'm Tony Zen, a product manager on the Microsoft Dynamics 365 Virtual Agent for Customer Service offering. What I'd like to do today is give you a quick overview of the experience to create your own virtual agent, to create a custom dialogue, test it out, and even deploy it to a test web page to see what the experience might look like from your end user's point of view. So to begin, start by clicking on the sign in button. The first time through, you'll actually be presented with some terms of service pages and some agreements that you'll need to agree to. Once you do that, you'll land here and then you can name your bot anything you want. So let's just call this a product troubleshooter bot. Now the first time through, this will take you up to 15 minutes. I've actually created one before, so the second bot is actually super quick to create. Now once I'm here, you'll land in the home page. And what you'll see here is a number of different places where you can quickly access different parts of the product, get more information on the product, including some of these demo videos. And you'll also see some pre-canned content that you can quickly use to go ahead and start talking to the virtual agent and just get a sense of what it can do. Our intention is not for you to necessarily use these in production, but it's to give you a sense of what types of dialogues you can go and create. Now, what we'll do today is let's go ahead and create a custom dialogue. And in fact, the scenario I have in mind is maybe we'll create a warranty checker that takes some product information like a product ID, serial number, or something like that, and actually dynamically look up whether or not the warranty for that product is still active. And I want to create a dialogue around that now. So to start, what I will do is I will actually click on the new topic button, and then I will go ahead and rename this. Let's say I rename it a warranty checker. And then I will enter in a number of different trigger phrases here. Now, what I'm doing with these trigger phrases is I'm actually providing some examples to our natural language understanding model so that it understands what types of user utterances should trigger this particular dialogue. Now, I don't need exact matches of everything here. Part of having our natural language understanding capability is that you can create some things that are good examples of this and representative examples, and we will go ahead and trigger this dialogue on things that sound similar to this. So once I'm done with this, I can go ahead and click Edit. This will now bring me into the authoring canvas itself. And as you'll see here, what I'm doing is I will get to the actual dialogue tree. Let's go ahead and close out the test bot here to give myself a little bit more room to work with. And I can now begin to author my dialogue visually. So first, maybe let me acknowledge that this is actually the topic that the user wants. And I can ask them if they know the serial number. From here, what I want to do is I actually want to create a simple branch. And so I can do that by using the user says option. And here I can basically present some different options to the user. So for example, I can do, yes, I know the serial number, or maybe I can ask, well, you know what? I actually don't know this. Where can I find my serial number? So you can see I've now authored a simple branching tree. If I go down the yes branch, I can actually say something like, please enter in my serial number. For the no branch, I can say something like, you know, here, let me give you some more information on where to go and find the serial number. Now let me continue down this yes branch here. What I want to do now is I actually want to take the user's response and save it down for later. So the way for me to do this is actually by using a variable. I will access that by again clicking on the user says. This time I don't need to create a branch, so let me go ahead and delete that part of it, but I do want to save my response to a variable. So let me create a new variable here and name it serial number. This one is a text type. We do support a couple other types right now, and we'll add in more over the coming months. But for now, a text type is fine. So once I do that, I can go ahead and remember the serial number, and then I can go ahead and pass it into a Microsoft flow by clicking on action. And when I look here, I actually have a couple different flows that I've already created. And so let me go ahead and use this one here, which checks my warranty status by my serial number. Now, when I click this, what I will see is the flow has been added to my dialogue. It's waiting for me to connect in the right input, which in this case is the serial number variable that I used from above. And this flow will actually then take the serial number and output a couple different things, including the status of the warranty, as well as the expiration date. Once I have this, I can actually write a dynamic routing condition using the expression. I actually don't need the serial number for this. What I want to do is I want to actually use the warranty status. And if the warranty is active, then I want to go down this branch. Otherwise, I will go down this other branch here. So in the case that the warranty is active, I want to actually just say that it is active. And maybe I want to put in the date that it's active until. And I have that from the output from the flow above. So I can go ahead and add that in, and now I'm done. So what's actually interesting about the product here is I've actually authored this particular branch of the tree. I actually haven't authored anything else, but even without authoring the rest of the dialogue, I can go ahead and save this and test it out immediately just to see if it's actually working properly. So first, let me hit save. Let me open up my TestBot window again by clicking on the icon in the lower left-hand corner. And let me click start over with the latest content so that what I just authored gets pushed into the TestBot here. And now I can go ahead and try this out. So one of the things I'll do is let me try out using a sample dialogue like I'd like to check if my device is under warranty. You'll notice here that this is actually not exactly like what I had trained my natural language model on, but that's okay. It actually, the bot is smart enough to know how to trigger this and how to trigger this appropriately here. The other thing I forgot to do here is actually turn on tracing. Now, if I turn on tracing, what I will do is it will actually highlight this along the way and it'll jump me from topic to topic. So as I redirect to other topics, it'll go ahead and automatically navigate me there so that I can kind of follow along with the dialogue automatically. So in this case, let's go ahead and try out the branch that I had authored, which was the yes branch. If I do this, you will see that the dialogue will actually navigate to that part of the tree. And let me go ahead and type in my serial number here. Again, this will now invoke the flow and pass on the serial number here to the backend system and check on the status of that warranty. Now, what just happened here was actually, we actually reached the end of that particular dialogue, automatically redirected to the end of conversation dialogue where I actually want to ask a survey question. Now, if I want to go back and look at the dialogue I authored, I can actually click on the chat bubble at any time, and this will bring me back to that point in the dialogue. So I can see that what happened was I went down the yes tree as I expected it to do. It actually was active, and in fact, the warranty expiration date was March 20th of 2020. And so you can see that I authored it in this way using this variable, and then at runtime, we dynamically passed in the correct parameter that came in from the backend system. So this is great. So this is actually working and I can see that it has worked. And in fact, I can go ahead and even continue authoring different parts of the tree. But for now, let me show you what you can do with this. Let's assume that I actually did finish off writing this dialogue. I can actually then go to the deploy page. That's okay, I can discard the changes here. And what I can do here is I can either deploy to a demo website or a custom website. If I click on the custom website, what you'll see is you have a snippet of code that allows you to basically embed this into your actual web page itself. At this point, obviously, I'm not ready to do that, but what I can do is maybe test it out on a little demo website and see what it might look like from my end user's point of view. So let me just say that this is a quick little demonstration, and maybe I'll do things like, you know, give a couple of different sample test phrases, and let me publish this. Once I publish this, what you'll see is it'll actually create another window here. You'll see also a link here that you can use to copy this and send this around to other people in order to share what that experience looks like. And that'll basically be the same as this link here, which you can also cut and paste from this part. And the main point of this website is to give you this iframe here, which shows you what the virtual agent looks like from your end user's point of view. So again, I can do things here like test out the virtual agent, test out the greeting topic, test out the warranty topic that I just authored, and I can actually start to play around with this now and see what this looks like. And so again, this is very similar to what I had done before, but now looking at it from my end user's point of view. So again, this is a great way to quickly start to author your own content and then test it out and be able to even go through all the rest of the dialogue, including some of the system topics, such as the greeting topic, as well as the end of conversation topic, which allows you to do things like a quick CSAT survey. And I can vote this, you know, this was excellent. And again, all of this comes right out of the box. Now, one more thing I can show you is, if I click back to my other tab here, I can click on analytics. Now, obviously, in this particular case, I don't have any analytics really to speak of. I just literally created the bot a couple minutes ago. But down the road, once you actually have your virtual agent running, then what you start to see here is you'll be able to see how many sessions have happened, things like the engagement rate, even things like what topics are working and are not working. And you can use this area here in order to get that information. The other piece you can do here is you can actually go over to the sessions. you can click download on the sessions, which allows you to then open up a CSV file with transcripts from these different dialogues. And these are the interactions that your users have had. And so if you look at this, for example, even the ones I just started and tried out, I can actually start to play around with this. And you can actually see some of the dialogues that actually transpired between your virtual agent and your end users. And so that's a very quick overview of the virtual agent experience. I hope you like that. If you have any questions, feel free to go ahead and click on our forums here and engage with us. We'd love to hear from you and hear any of the feedback you have. Thanks so much.